Hi, greetings all. Today the topic for discussion is plane electromagnetic waves in conducting medium, 5th unit electromagnetic fields. So the waves the wave equation for conducting medium is given by del square E minus mu epsilon dou square E by dou t square minus mu sigma dou E by dou t equal to 0. So the previous classes we discussed about the waves in lossless dielectric and lossy dielectric. So for a dielectrics, so this term will not be there, the conductivity term will not be there, only there will be the dielectric current. So we'll be having the first two terms. For the conducting medium, we have the wave equation as del square E minus mu epsilon dou square E by dou t square minus mu sigma dou E by dou t equal to 0. So this is the wave equation for the conducting medium. And when we represent this equation in phasor form, so as usual, dou by dou t can be written as j omega. Dou square by dou t square can be replaced with j omega the whole square. So as such, we can write as del square E minus mu epsilon. So since dou square by dou t square, it is j square omega square E minus. So here j mu sigma j omega E equal to 0. So this we have represented in phasor form. So and j square can be replaced with minus 1. So here del square E minus j omega, so here minus j omega mu E, take it outside. So here, so you take this j omega E, take outside. Okay, so we have taken j omega E outside. So minus j omega mu E into j omega epsilon plus sigma equal to 0. So this term can be written as gamma. Okay, so this del square E minus gamma square E equal to 0, where gamma square is j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon. So this term and j omega mu, so this term is gamma square. So it can be written as del square E minus gamma square E equal to 0. So gamma equal to, so when you take square root of this, so we will take square root of this, this gamma is called the propagation constant, alpha is the attenuation constant, and beta is the phase constant. So gamma equal to alpha plus j beta equal to, take square root of this. So root of j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon. So now it takes square on both sides. So alpha plus j beta the whole square, to remove the square root there. So alpha plus j beta the whole square, so which is given by a square plus b square plus 2ab. So j beta the whole square will become minus beta square. So alpha square minus beta square plus 2j alpha beta equal to, so the right hand side this square root goes off. So j omega mu, multiply this, sigma minus omega square, so j into j minus minus, so minus omega square mu epsilon. So this expression we are arriving at. Now you equate the real and imaginary parts. So in equating the real and imaginary parts, so this is the real parts. So alpha square minus beta square equal to minus omega square mu epsilon. Okay, so alpha square minus beta square equal to minus omega square epsilon. And equating the imaginary parts, so the imaginary part is 2 alpha beta, so here it is omega mu sigma. So we have 2 alpha beta equal to omega mu sigma. Okay, now what we are doing is you write general expression for alpha square plus beta square. So alpha square plus beta square can also be written as from alpha square minus beta square the whole square. If you add the term 4 alpha square beta square, so you will be getting this, the resultant for this equation is alpha square plus beta square. So alpha square plus beta square can be written as root of alpha square minus beta square the whole square plus 4 alpha square beta square. So and also this is one of the expressions, and you take square of this equation, so alpha square minus beta square the whole square equal to omega power 4 mu square epsilon square. So we have two equations, one is for alpha square plus beta square, another one is for alpha square minus beta square. Okay, so also you take square of this equation, so 4 alpha square beta square equal to omega square mu square sigma square. So this is the expression. So this is the expression. And as I said, we have two expressions. One is alpha square plus beta square. Another one is alpha square minus beta square. Mark these two as equation numbers 1 and 2. If you add these two equations, what will happen? Alpha square plus alpha square, 2 alpha square. So this plus beta square and minus beta square will be getting cancelled. So you have 2 alpha square equal to, so you are adding these two equations. So minus omega square mu epsilon plus root of omega power 4 mu square epsilon square plus omega square mu square sigma square. Okay. Now you divide it by 2, so alpha square equal to minus omega square mu epsilon by 2 plus So when you divide by this this equation by 2, and also you take omega square mu epsilon by 2 outside. Okay, when you take this 2 omega square mu epsilon by 2 outside, so you take it inside, you will be having 1 plus sigma square by omega square epsilon square. As you know, sigma by omega epsilon is the last tangent. Okay, so now we take alpha. Alpha is the square root of this term, so we have alpha equal to root of omega square mu epsilon by 2 into, again inside you have root 1 plus sigma square by omega epsilon square minus 1. So this we have taken this term as outside. So we have taken the omega square mu epsilon by 2 as outside, so only we are arriving here, we have 1 minus 1. Okay, so when you take alpha, alpha equal to, so take omega square root of omega square is omega. So omega root of mu epsilon by 2 into root of 1 plus sigma square by omega epsilon square minus 1. Similarly, when we subtract 2 from 1, so here we have 2, alpha square plus beta square, alpha square minus square. When you subtract these two, so you will be obtaining the expression for beta square. Okay, so beta equal to root of, this will be the expression. Following the same procedure, you will be applying the expression for beta as omega root mu epsilon by 2 into root of 1 plus sigma square by omega square epsilon square plus 1. So this is the expression. These are the wave parameters. So wave parameters means nothing but the attenuation constant, phase constant, intrinsic impedance and propagation constant. These are the wave parameters. So we have derived the wave parameters for waves in a plane, waves in a conducting medium. Okay, so for the conducting medium, we have to use different wave equations. For perfect dielectric, we have to use different wave equations. For the conductive medium, we have an additional expression of minus mu sigma by dou E by dou T. So this additional term is there for conducting medium. Okay, so we are arriving at different wave parameters, alpha, beta and gamma. So we have this is the expression for attenuation and phase constants for conducting medium. Previously we have derived for dielectric medium. Okay, now and also for good conductors, if we consider good conductors, so the sigma by omega epsilon term is very much greater than 1. So because as far as conductors are considered, sigma means conductivity. So conductivity is high for conductor, and for dielectric this omega epsilon term is will be very much higher. So here when you derive for good conductors, this sigma will be very much greater than omega epsilon, or sigma square omega by omega epsilon square term is very much greater than 1. So it will be some 10,000 like that. So here it will be 1. So this term can be neglected. So this 1, this minus 1 and plus 1 can be neglected. So what you will be having is, simply you will be having here, you will be having sigma by omega epsilon. So sigma by omega epsilon means this epsilon will be cancelled. So finally, you will be arriving at the expression of alpha equal to beta equal to root of pi f mu sigma. So the attenuation constant is equal to the phase constant equal to root of pi into f into mu into sigma, where mu is the permeability, sigma is the conductivity, f is the frequency and of course pi value is 3.14. okay, so these are the expressions we have derived for the attenuation constant and phase constant for good conductors. Okay, and okay, so we'll conclude. So we have derived the expression for the waves in conducting medium. So previously we have used the different set of wave equations for dielectric, and for conducting medium we have to include an additional term due to conductivity. For dielectric, conductivity is 0, so you will be neglecting this term, but for conducting medium we have to include this term from the Maxwell's equations. Okay, so we have represented in phasor form, and we have derived the expressions for attenuation constant, phase constant, and also we have derived at the last tangent. Last tangent is this term, sigma by omega epsilon, and we are arriving at equations as alpha equal to beta equal to root of pi f mu sigma. Next class we will discuss about plane waves reflection and refraction. So when the wave propagates from one medium to another medium, how the waves are getting reflected. So how the waves are getting reflected or refracted. If it passes through the same medium, it is called as refraction. So how the waves are getting reflection and refraction. And if it, the incidence, two types of incidence will be considered. One is normal incidence, that is perpendicular. Normal means always perpendicular, 90 degree. If the incident wave is 90 degree to the surface, or oblique incidence. Oblique means on any other angle other than 90 degree. So these two cases we'll see. But as far as the syllabus is concerned, you have been included as only normal incidents. Maybe if sometimes oblique incidents is asked, please be thorough with that also. Okay. Questions for this class? State wave equations for the conducting medium. As we know, wave equations for dielectric medium is different from the set of wave equations for the conducting medium. So additionally, we have one term which contains the sigma. Okay. Second question is derive expressions for attenuation constant and phase constant for a good conductor. So we are arriving at, finally we will be arriving at the expression of alpha equal to root of pi f mu sigma. Okay. What is the criterion for expression for loss tangent for good conductor? For good conductor, sigma will be very much greater than omega epsilon. And as far as dielectric is concerned, sigma is very much less than omega epsilon. With this, we'll end up with the session. Have a nice time.